Good morning, fellow bullionaires. This is Silver 5150 with your weekend update for Saturday, October 23rd, 2021. Well, guys, in case you hadn't noticed, I've been out of the game for a bit, and let's just say it was due to a private pandemic battle, and leave it at that. Now, I will say while I was laid up, I had the opportunity to look around to see if I noticed anything unusual in the silver world, and guess what? Amongst recent talk of a silver blank shortage at the Royal Mint, I did see two things. Strange metals that were not silver being made available along with similar silver offerings, and sovereign silver bullion coinage for, get ready, $2,500 an ounce. You heard me right. Sovereign silver bullion coinage for $2,500 an ounce. Not gold, silver. And this is just out of the Royal Mint. So with that in mind, I decided this was important enough to consult my favorite silver acquisition philosopher, the Silver Joker. Silver Joker, thanks for coming on the show this morning.
Oh, man, my pleasure, man. Thank you very much for inviting me.
You are welcome.
So I know you've been a little sick, man, and I don't know if you want me to bring it up on the show, but I just wonder how you're doing. How you getting along?
Well, you know, it is what a lot of people expect it might be. And I'm actually pretty much on the other side of it. Some final recovery and stuff. I think it's been working out really well. You know, I've had, you know, all these people looking out for me. Mm-hmm. I'm going to pull through. I've got people checking on me all the time. I got silver brothers like yourself always blessing me with nice gifts, huh?
Yeah, I did. I sent you a get well gift. I think a few of them. I guess I'm going to hear about it. I don't know if I can ask you
now.
Oh,
yes, sir. You're going to hear about it. You're going to hear about it.
Yes. So you got that. I'm glad you got my gift.
I did. And I got to tell you guys now, before we get to our topic, check these out real quick. You know, Silver Joker, you know, he comes through, man. I needed something to comfort me and to bring me around and to snap me back to reality and inspire me to get the hell out of bed. A classic silver round I have here depicting what I believe is a graduation of sorts. Okay. When I look at it, I can see like the diploma and stuff on it, which I can imagine if Silver Joker actually handed it to me, he'd be like, "Congratulations, son, you lived."
Yeah.
Just like a Marine.
Well, I mean, you know, the proof of that is here. I mean, you're talking to me. You sound a lot better. You know, I've been checking on you periodically. And I think the last time I spoke to you, you sounded a lot different than you sound today. So
oh,
I'm
man.
Glad to hear
I
that
did.
You sound a lot better. And I'm going to say that it's because of my gift.
I think it was,
pulled you through. Mm-hmm. So
that's it. If not for you, I'd still sound like Barry White.
I'm going to take full credit for that.
You're
right. Welcome.
Well, take credit for this. How about, guys, the coolest buffalo I've ever gotten. I'm not joking. Given the incredible toning on this thing, I just love it. It's awesome. And as cool as that buffalo is, you guys know, we're talking about the Silver Joker, the King of Constitutional. He's not going to leave me without any Constitutional. And here, of course, we have two of these cool-ass Kennedy halves. All right? But we are going to hit our subject for today. And just so you know, that even though I'm asking the Silver Joker about these anomalies that I noticed when I was laid up, my question is actually for the entire Silver 5150 Army. So please feel free to leave your comments down in the comments below. All right, Silver Joker, are you ready?
I believe I am. I'm not sure quite what's coming next.
No, I always love to leave you just kind of twisting the wind. But you know what? You are a quick reaction force. You're a Marine. You got this. Well, I'm not going to sing you a song, that's for sure.
Okay, thank you. But I can handle whatever comes next. Then,
right? Okay, there you go. So look, first up, Silver Joker, first up. We've got this Virenium Pegasus, which has been lingering around on Abnex for a long time. Now, this Virenium Pegasus, it's pretty much the same design from the British Virgin Islands 2018 Pegasus. Like, I have those, I believe, in the 5-ounce version. Okay, but outside of that being a Pegasus, what is Virenium? Is it precious?
Well, not exactly. No, it's not considered precious. And it's amazing to me that they're making them out of Virenium. I mean, I know that some high denomination coins are coinage is made out of Virenium. But, I thought that was kind of a novelty thing. But to have the Royal Mint, well, actually, it's a silver colored metal alloy. And from my understanding, it's in the nickel family. And I think it's mostly made out of copper and nickel and zinc. And I think they put some other base metals in there to kind of strengthen it. But that's mainly what I think that's made for, is like the high denomination.
So it would be a high-end coinage for circulation, I would think. You know, and I think about that, too. I think about, Because the version I see here on the website is a highly polished version. It looks very nice. It has a dollar denomination on it.
Yeah, that is really a nice looking coin there.
So it'd be like the kind of the proof circulated coins that we get out of the mint, mm-hmm. I guess.
I would say, yeah, something like that. Mm-hmm.
So we've got the Virenium, which is not silver. Okay, next we have, now remember, guys, we're talking about the Royal Mint, and this is under the backdrop of them having a silver blank shortage here recently. This was something that was made clear by some of the big carriers that carry their products, all right? Next up, we have, out of the Royal Mint, a 95th birthday of the Queen coin, all right? Which, at a glance, looks like it could be silver.
But it looks like silver to me.
Yeah, but look at that price tag there. What do you think of that?
Well, that's either they're giving silver away or there's something else going on.
Something's going on. So I looked a little deeper. I'm like, it must be half an ounce. That's what it actually is. I bet it's a half an ounce. So I look in there. I go into the description, into the product description stuff. And it actually turns out that these things are 1 troy ounce of Cupro-Nickel. Silver Joker, what the heck is Cupro-Nickel?
Cupro-Nickel? They're making coins out of Cupro-Nickel?
Yeah.
Okay, well, Cupro-Nickel is the fancy term. A lot of us just say copper nickel. And really what it is, it's used in the military. That's how I know a little bit about it, mm-hmm. but it's like, it's usually made out of 60 to 90% copper. And then the rest being, nickel, and that nickel is usually strengthened. You know, it's got strengtheners in there of, iron and magnesium.
Oh, okay.
And really it's used in a lot of applications that deal with seawater. So a lot of marine applications, some real high end boat hulls. I mean, you're talking about high end yachts and those kind of things would be made out of Cupro-Nickel. And this would have been years ago, if I'm correct. I mean, I'm sure that people will correct me in the comments, but I think, coins were made because they have that silver color. And right. I think the ratio then was like 3-to-1 nickel to copper ratio there
right.
when they made coins. But, that's kind of bizarre that the Royal Mint would be using that to make coins. I mean, I didn't know that the mints are still doing that.
Well, I think the thing I find a little uncanny about it also is that they seem to end up on display with the silver offerings at the same time, which I guess if you wanted to stay consistent with the design, you would do that. You know, it's all one category. It's like those alien coins we got from Ghana,
mm-hmm.
where they had like the 5 different kinds and stuff. Right. But they were all precious metals, mm-hmm. like these. All right. So it's just something to kind of mull about, and now it's got me thinking a lot about, especially when you said they were, marine proof, this sort of thing that they want.
Yeah. I mean, they're highly resistant to seawater corrosion, saltwater corrosion. That metal is.
Right.
And so I don't know why they would want to make a coin out of that unless they thought there were going to be some ships going down.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Shipwreck coins. Yeah, exactly.
But I mean, they wouldn't really be worth that much. I mean, it's just nickel and copper. But
they'd only have the dark history tied to them. All right. But anyway, we'll come back to that. Mm-hmm. Last but not least, we have the 2 ounce Three Graces proof. Now, this is a 2 ounce silver proof, guys, out of the Royal Mint. It's a Three Graces proof, 2 ounce proof. For $5,000. Now, it's $4,996 or something like that. It could change tomorrow because the spot price is moving up. Woohoo! However, my point is that it's 2 ounces of silver for $5,000. All right? Now, just give you guys some reference. Recently, I made a purchase, and it was the most expensive silver purchase I ever made in my life. And it was those 2 Qiang Nan Silver Kilo Dragon Dollar Restrikes. I got both of those for $4,700. Both of those. For $300 less than this 1 2-ounce silver coin.
Wow.
So my question to you, Silver Joker, and the Silver 5150 Army, look, given that the Royal Mint regularly issues base metal coinage at what used to be silver bullion prices, Cupro-Nickel, while they are simultaneously selling some silver for $2,500 an ounce, what is the Royal Mint trying to tell us? Have they inadvertently blown the lid on silver price suppression? The whole scheme. Silver Joker. Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure that there's a silver shortage. In the technical term of silver, I mean, there's plenty of silver in the ground. I just think the shortage is coming from their ability to get it to us. And I think that they're feeling it. And so they're coming up with an alternative to their to the metals that they're going to use to make these collectible coins.
Right. And, now that I think about it, too, you got me on that same train, is that if you could somehow get people to part with $2,500 an ounce for silver, then you can technically take that cash or whatever that purchasing unit of exchange is going to be out of circulation against what would have been probably 90 ounces of silver at current prices, or 80 ounces of silver bullion. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that's a good way to make your silver stretch far if you're, you know, kind of short on it.
Yeah. You know, there's a lot of stuff. Like the video I did about all those ships just, you know, just milling around out there off of the coast of California waiting to come in to port. Because they don't have the workers to you know, to offload them and those kind of things. And you know, I think that we're going to feel the crunch from that on a lot of levels. And silver, well, precious metals could very well be one of those pressure points.
So look, gold and silver, they're going to be the top of this game. All right, it's just know you're in the right asset class and continue to stack your silver, man. You're going to be so glad you did. Silver Joker, thank you so much for hanging out this morning. It would have been tough to get to the show without you. And for those listening today, where can people find your work?
They're going to find it at the Silver Joker channel, YouTube. And I also have an Instagram, Silver Joker. You can go over there and check out some of my posts over there. You guys might enjoy that.
Okay, right. So look, thank you, Silver Joker, for coming around. Appreciate it, man.
Very welcome. Very welcome.
All right. Friend. All right. And guys, that's going to do it for today. Silver 5150 telling you your stack is not whack. And that just 30 ounces to your name, 30 ounces with everything that's going on right now, keeps you 99% ahead of the game. Most of those things that we reference here today, I'll try to leave a link in the description below for. And if you enjoyed the show today, please like, share, subscribe, comment, and be sure to follow us on Instagram as well when you're out there looking for Silver Joker. Enjoy the rest of your weekend, folks, and take care. Ciao, Bella.
Take it easy.